My bad. I'm like, what are we talking about?
I'll be able to check the chat here in a moment. I'm just making sure my notes are editing. We're not certified to diagnose or anything, but information is out there, which individuals can use to look for characteristics and signs of toxicity in online environments. And welcome, Little Plastic Castles.
Hey, Johnny.
Welcome to
not one thing. Revenge porn. Trying to say a revenge porn.
Psychopathic online influencers. And we're going to take a look at some things that they can do, and often do, participate in order to damage people.
Let's go!
Jewish, Puerto Rican, Jamaican, Portuguese. Trey White, so must be German.
But first, I think it's very important for us to take a look into what exactly constitutes psychopathy.
This is like the level to it, guys. It's pretty simple.
And so we're going to take a look at this. So go through these notes. So bear with me here, but psychopathy is a complex personality disorder characterized by a combination of behavioral, emotional, and interpersonal traits.
Quickly, like the fucking first sign of pressure, my guy's first fucking thoughts was.
While it is important to note that only a trained professional can diagnose psychopathy, here are some commonly observed characteristics. One of the first character traits of a psychopath is a lack of empathy. Psychopaths often have a natural capacity, have a reduced capacity for empathy and struggle to understand or connect with the emotions of others. They may have difficulty recognizing or responding to the needs and feelings of those around them.
It'd be great if everyone had the same viewpoint. Right, but it's not about having the same viewpoint. It's about, like, that's a line that most people know that that's a gross line to cross. So, like,
now, these are typically, in my opinion, these are often people who will talk about how it's always about feeling. Now, there are some people who get sick of hearing it, of course, but who are the ones who are going to speak the most vehemently about other people discussing their feelings? Why? Interesting today that I saw that somebody has my minor child's phone number. I'm going to be looking into that one.
Do you support people that cross that line? Right? I don't want anything to do with you.
They may use various tactics such as lying, deception, and exploitation to achieve their objectives. Stability. Psychopaths tend to have a short sighted perspective and a disregard for long-term planning or commitment. They may engage in impulsive behaviors without considering future consequences and have difficulty maintaining stable relationships.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, stay with me. On my day 3 crying for Cash Apps, that was nice of everybody.
To get that hook in the mouth of the individual who comes in because they're trying to build a followership, which can captivate their viewers and gain their trust. They may use their charm to create a facade of authenticity and relatability, making it easier to manipulate their followers.
Yeah.
Next up, we have, we've already read about the emotional manipulation, but these influencers are adept at manipulating the emotions of their audience. They may use guilt, fear, or sympathy to provoke strong emotional responses, thereby encouraging their followers to engage more with their content. Share it widely, or even donate money. Now, yesterday we were talking about these tactics where they pull things out of context. There's currently these creators who are a couple who are under attack right now, and their videos are being pulled out of context. And the only ones that the leader of this online cult is having their followers watch are the ones that put them in a negative light. Now, these people have not had anything. They've not had any criminal charges against them, right? But there were allegations, just like there were allegations when the police showed up at my door last week, 2 days after I essentially had a breakdown, 2 days following that night.
Idiots. And hate fuck doesn't mean fuck it. They're so stupid. This is the problem, right? This is the problem.
That is what it boils down to. Number three, gaslighting and manipulative language. Psychopathic influencers may employ gaslighting techniques, intentionally distorting reality or making their audience doubt their own perceptions. It saddened me today because as I was downloading the chat log, I saw this person saying that they had my son's number. And the people in the chat were like, like they were encouraging this person to call my son.
You know, someone should, like, you should be embarrassed at that thought, too. Like, those thoughts that come out of that dude's fucking head, my guy should be embarrassed that the fact that those thoughts pop into his head.
Who you think you talking to, bitch? I don't give a fuck who I'm talking to. See yourself out the fucking shop, bro. See yourself out, dog. You know what I'm saying? That's who I'm talking to. Some fucking random person in my chat, bro, that doesn't come here ever and came here to try and talk shit. That's who I'm talking to. That's all you are to me, right? You're going to leave the chat and I'll forget about you, right? You understand that? You can leave your house today, get hit by a fucking bus, and it wouldn't make no difference to my life. Who are you, right?
How many of you in this chat and online, you live with some form of disability or mental illness, and you've fallen prey to this stuff? Mm-hmm. We are all the type of people that they want to get their claws on.
That's
many of us spend most of our lives at home. Many of us do not have much of a social life outside of the walls of our homes. Many of us are looking for a place of belonging and some sense of community, which makes us perfect, vulnerable targets.
Nobody. The fuck out of here. Y'all on some crazy shit. Come in here, think you're smart, talking stupid. Imagine that. Only stupid people think you're smart. You understand? Only stupid people think you're smart. Don't try it. I check your ass like a looter in a riot.